Good day. So I'd like to talk about one of the most classic ghost-busting teams there is. That's right, Ajax Ghost Exterminators.
Who?
Well, they're better known as Mickey, Donald, and Goofy. So as usual, let's recap the episode really quick, and then I'll flap my gums some more about some stuff after. So, alright, let's go.
Alright, so this is a pretty quick one, so let's just get right into it.
So,
there is a quartet of ghosts, and they are inhabiting the empty McShiver mansion.
And they're totally bored. They don't have anybody to hunt, nobody to scare, man. Like,
oh, whoa, are these ghosts? What are they gonna do?
Like, could they go somewhere else and hunt some other place? Or like,
well, maybe ghosts are tethered to a certain place for some reason, so maybe that's why they're stuck there?
Yeah, I guess, yeah, that makes sense. Let's go with that.
So they have to bring people into the place.
As luck would have it, one of the ghosts finds an advertisement for the Ajax Ghost Exterminators in a newspaper.
How long has that fairly updated newspaper been there, man? This place looks like it hasn't been inhabited in, like, decades. Ajax Ghost Exterminators can't have been around for that long. Does that place still get newspaper delivery?
Anywho,
the ghosts figure it'd be super awesome if they can get Ajax to the mansion just so they can screw around with those ghost exterminators and actually have some fun.
And so they do.
So the Ajax Ghost Exterminating crew consists of Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, and Goofy.
They are more than happy to take the call.
They show up at the mansion
and are immediately totally getting played by the ghosts.
The trio decide it's probably best if they split up and try to kind of round the ghosts up that way.
But
wouldn't you know it? Their fantastic ghost exterminating weapons of a shotgun, a net, and an axe really have no effect on these ghosts. And then we have the ghosts messing around with each of the Ajax exterminators, one by one, just totally messing with them.
They give Mickey a pretty good run for his money,
they terrorize Donald Duck, and eventually they get Goofy trapped in a dresser. As he's trapped in that dresser, the ghosts throw him down a staircase
where he collides with Mickey and Donald,
and they all smash into a giant pile of containers with molasses, syrup, and flour. So now they're all covered in this absolute guck, all stringy and sticky, and somehow very alluring.
As the ghosts come down the staircase to further humiliate these ghost exterminators,
they think that there's actually a crazy, massive-looking ghost in the house, and the ghosts freak out.
They run off, gone, nowhere to be seen.
What?
You're telling me ghosts are scared of other ghosts?
Could that make sense?
Like, I guess, hey, there's like different level of ghosthood, I guess?
These guys are like, you know, at a certain level, maybe they thought that big gooey cluck there was like some demonic ghost that they don't want to mess with that.
No, that's too much.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
So that would really open up the different classifications and powers of different ghosts and how they interact with each other.
This silly little cartoon is just getting deeper.
If they ran away from the house, then I guess they weren't tethered to that house, so they could have gone somewhere else to hunt.
Oh well, don't really matter, because at the end of the day, Ajax got the ghosts chased out of the house, and the day is saved.
Well, for now, the ghosts weren't exterminated, so maybe they'll meet up with them later, who knows?
But until then, that is the end of this fantastic little tale.
Well, I guess probably not the best ghost-busting team ever assembled, but they got the job done. And still, like, fairly historic if you're talking ghost-busting teams, because this was the first ghost-busting team that was ever shown on film.
Like a team, as in like a whole ghost-busting company, not just some random people thrown together with pitchforks and torches, but like an actual legitimate ghost hunting team.
So it is kind of funny. This is actually one of the classic Disney shorts. The original short that was shown was roughly, 5 minutes or so long? Which is kind of funny because there's an extended version, the Gillett Cut. Like, the original version was 9 minutes long, and they cut it down.
So the version that I kind of showed and kind of reviewed for this was the extended version. Sure, the cut down version really kind of flowed a whole lot better, but there was a little bit more meat and potatoes to the story in the extended version.
So for example, in the cut scenes, the ghosts complained that they were bored and that they should find something to do, which wound up them calling Ajax. When the Ajax crew was separated and the ghosts attacked each member one
by one, those scenes were fleshed out quite a bit more. Mickey had a heck of a time with these ghosts. Donald Duck actually got a pretty solid right hook on one of the ghost's jaw. The only time in the whole thing a ghost was on the losing end of something. And Goofy had much of a longer scene where he was playing that mirror trick with a ghost at the clothes dresser. That scene kind of really dragged on, so it was a good thing they cut that, but the rest of it was like awesome. But both versions are available, so yeah, for sure, watch both of them and let me know which one you like better. I just wish we'd seen more of this ghost team, man, because it's actually pretty awesome kind of setup, especially nowadays with some really popular ghost teams that have happened. Maybe it's not too late to kind of bring these guys back. You know, of course, you'd have to slightly update everything, but you know, it could be done. If anyone at Disney is watching, which I really doubt, but hey, here's my pitch for the show. So instead of these guys having really dumb equipment that makes no sense for ghost busting, you can get Professor Ludwig von Drake to kind of come up with some modernized version of their equipment. So Mickey, instead of having a shotgun, he can have a ghost tranquilizer gun. Donald's net could be modified technologically somehow to actually catch a ghost instead of a ghost just going right through it. And Goofy with an axe, yeah, that's a bit hardcore. You can change that axe to maybe a baseball bat, and that could be a close range kind of ghost, kind of a stunner as well, or something, you know, just spitballing. But that would be awesome to see, right? Like, these guys are the original ghost exterminating team. Let's see them in action again. We'll probably never see that happen, but in the meantime, let's talk some more about this cartoon.
Okay, so let's get right to the Ajax Ghost Exterminating Company. So, if we look on their back wall, we notice there is a diploma hanging from Ghost College. So these guys have some form of training, which is pretty good. If we look slightly to the left of the diploma, we do see their arsenal of ghost catching weaponry, you know, things that make total sense, like a musket, a shotgun, an axe, a baseball bat, and a croquet mallet. All of those things, certified ghost exterminating stuff, right? How would any of those possibly have any effect on a ghost? I'm starting to think that this ghost college is some sort of a scam. Well, that, or ghost college has no idea what a ghost is. Maybe they think a ghost is a giant rodent. Then yeah, a croquet mallet would make sense in that regard. Their other piece of equipment is in a blink and you'll miss it scene. They do have a vehicle, which is a white car. Colored van or truck, however you want to call it from back then. The Ajax crew do seem pretty confident in being able to exterminate or chase out the ghosts when they enter McShiver Mansion, so it makes me think that this is not their first job of busting ghosts. And speaking of these ghosts, like, let's theorize as to what happened to these guys in life. Based on their clothes, with the cloak and the derby hat and all, it looks like they were more than likely alive during the Victorian era, which would have been at the later half of the 1800s. So these ghosts could have been ghosts for like, say, 50 years or so at the point of this cartoon in 1937, give or take. In the extended version of the cartoon, they are using water a lot to fight Ajax crew, so maybe possibly these guys drowned somewhere, either at sea or on a river or something. And it just might be me, but I've always got the impression that in life, these guys were part of some sort of a gang or a mob. Maybe that's why they dressed so precisely exact the same way. That was just their gang uniform, but I don't know, maybe that's just me. Maybe I've been watching Clockwork Orange too much and just, you know, kind of figure everyone dresses the same. And if I channel my inner Egon Spengler and classify these ghosts, they would obviously be poltergeists. What with their mischievous antics and all, the way they interact with the physical world, and their use of violence. Yep, pretty poltergeisty. So, as it is inevitable, let us compare the Ajax Ghost Exterminators to other ghost busting teams. Let's start off with the 1975 Filmation Ghostbusters. So right off the bat, both teams are a three-piece group. Their offices are very similar. They're both quite dilapidated. They both have their names on the front door in similar fashion, and they both hang around a big desk, which is centralized in the office room. The character Jake Kong is dressed quite similarly to Goofy. They both have a large bag of equipment that they lug around per every case, and they both have that fantastic older white vehicle. So yeah, pretty fair to say that the film Filmation Ghostbusters were heavily influenced by this Lonesome Ghosts cartoon. So let's take a look at the similarities between this one and the 1984 Columbia Pictures Ghostbusters. Well, they both were a three-piece team for a while, until they became a four-piece team with Winston joining. So we're somewhat similar for a bit anyway. They both have a fantastic white vehicle. One is definitely better looking than the other one. In the extended cut, Goofy said, "I ain't a scared of no ghost." One of the taglines for the Ghostbusters is, "I ain't afraid of no ghost," which was one of the main lyrics in the Ghostbusters theme song from Ray Parker Jr. This one's a bit of a stretch, but it kind of got me similar vibes when Mickey said, "Ho ho, a customer!" That to me was pretty similar to Janine when she exclaimed, "We got one!" when they got their first Ghostbusting call. Kind of similar. And at the end of both features, both teams were completely covered in some sticky goo, like from head to toe. So yeah, two teams that don't mind getting dirty to get the job done. So yeah, I wish there was more stories with this Ajax Ghost Exterminators. Would have been pretty cool to see, but this one, as is pretty legendary, even though a lot of it makes no sense. But either way, that's all I have for that. But yeah, other than that, I guess that's that.
Right on, and there you go.
So thanks for watching the video. I hope you liked it as much as I did making it. Also, feel free to check out the source material that I featured in this video. And if you want to leave a comment on anything you may have liked or things I might have missed in this, you know, feel free to do so. Or anything else, you know, just to say hi. That's cool too. And other than that, you know, have a great day. Thanks.